free. The skin you're in with no apology. The one to seize the day. Grab an LLB. Live love be. Angostura, lemon, lime and bitters. Live, love, be.
Want to get away? Now you can.
Stop standing in long ATM lines to withdraw cash. Use your national debit or black cards to complete a wide variety of transactions at supermarkets, variety stores, gas stations, pharmacies, and more. Shop online at the most popular websites and stores for quality brands using your national debit or black cards. And take back your time to enjoy all the things that you love to do. Remember, instead of waiting in long ATM lines to withdraw cash, use your national bank cards today.
National Bank, always here.
Like the dude who was shopping at furniture and appliances.
See, my friend, you look like you buy something from the Ashley Home Store.
How you know?
Because we get the cashback coupons.
Top stories. Police investigating shooting in Nevis. Governor General receives credentials from UK High Commissioner. And UK High Commissioner holds virtual meeting with Prime Minister Harris. The details on these stories and more after the break.
Without limits, happy and free. The skin you're in with no apology. The one to seize the day. Grab an LLB. Live, love, be. Angostura, lemon, lime and bitters. Live, love, be.
Hello and welcome to the Zedizer Channel 5 newscast. I'm Calla Berridge. The police are investigating a shooting incident in Nevis that has left one person hospitalized. According to a police source, the incident occurred at Pump Road at about 3 o'clock on Thursday morning. As investigations are still underway, the details are unclear, but the police have confirmed a man from Stony Grove was shot and injured, and he is now warded at the Alexandra Hospital. Meanwhile, police have released more information regarding a double homicide on Tuesday night. Preliminary investigations so far have revealed that 36-year-old Kyle Cleveland Williams and 29-year-old Akeem Paris, both residents of Catty Alley, were sitting at the junction of George Street and Catty Alley when armed masked assailants approached and fired several gunshots in their direction. Both men were struck several times about the body. Williams died at the scene and Paris was transported to the JNF General Hospital where he succumbed to his injuries. The scene was processed by personnel from the Forensic Services Unit and several pieces of evidence were taken into custody. The police are asking anyone with information to call the nearest police station or the crime hotline at 707 where information can be given anonymously. Investigations are ongoing. The following is a press release from Government House. On Thursday morning at Government House, His Excellency the Governor General, Sir S.W. Tapley-Seaton, GCMG, CVO, QCJ, PLLD, received a courtesy call from the new British High Commissioner, His Excellency Mr. Scott Fursdon Wood, MBO. This was held virtually. The High Commissioner was a part of the entourage of His Royal Highness, the Prince of Wales, during his visit to the Federation on March 21, 2019. The High Commissioner had earlier presented his letter of introduction from the United Kingdom Prime Minister, Boris Johnson, to the Prime Minister of the Federation, Dr. the Honourable Timothy Harris, MPJP. Their Excellencies discussed matters of mutual interest, such as scholarships, climate change, the ongoing discussions regarding the Windrush generation, cultural arts, and the promotion of issues of concern. The new British High Commissioner to St. Kitts and Nevis, His Excellency Scott Fursdon Wood, reaffirmed the friendship and historic ties between the Federation and the United Kingdom as he presented his credentials to Prime Minister Dr. the Honourable Timothy Harris during a virtual meeting on Wednesday. Among the substantive matters discussed were issues of climate change, rebuilding in the face of COVID-19, renewable energy development, partnerships with the United Kingdom, prison reform and trade. Prime Minister Harris, in accepting the credentials, indicated that there has long been a special relationship between both countries. The Prime Minister also stated that there is a need for further consolidation of this special relationship in ways that would bring tangible benefits for St. Kitts and Nevis. His Excellency Fursdon Wood is based in Barbados and leads the UK's recently expanded diplomatic presence in the Eastern Caribbean. He assumed duties there in April 2021. After the break, a travel advisory extended and UWE event scaled down. Stay with us.
Want to get away? Now you can.
Stop standing in long ATM lines to withdraw cash. Use your national debit or black cards to complete a wide variety of transactions at supermarkets, variety stores, gas stations, pharmacies, and more. Shop online at the most popular websites and stores for quality brands using your national debit or black cards. And take back your time to enjoy all the things that you love to do. Remember, instead of waiting in long ATM lines to withdraw cash, use your national bank cards today.
National Bank, always here.
Like the dude who was shopping at furniture and appliances.
See, my friend, you look like you buy something from the Ashley Home Store.
How you know?
Because we get the cashback coupons and the free groceries for a year.
Cashback is back at Horsford's Furniture and Appliances and Ashley Furniture. Shop now and get a chance to win free groceries for 1 year.
Your safety and convenience are most important to us at Flow. That's why we provide many ways for you to keep your account connected, which now includes FastPay, the new convenient payment option on our website. No registration required. Or download the MyFlow app to pay anytime from anywhere on your smartphone or tablet. If you wish to pay your bill in person, feel free to visit any of our fully sanitized branches. Flow is committed to helping you stay connected. Let's do this together.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back. St. Kitts and Nevis has further extended the travel advisory for travelers arriving from the UK, Brazil, India, and South Africa as of July 19, 2021 until August 31, 2021. According to a statement from the St. Kitts Tourism Authority, persons from those destinations are advised not to travel to St. Kitts and Nevis at this time. Entry into the Federation will be denied. Citizens and residents of St. Kitts and Nevis who are arriving from any of these countries must process their travel request through the online platform www.knatravelform.kn. The statement said the government is extending the advisory in response to COVID-19 variants that have originated in the UK, Brazil, South Africa, and India. Of particular concern at this time is the Delta variant. The Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis will continue to monitor the developing situation and will provide updates accordingly. Citizens and residents who have been fully vaccinated for 2 weeks or more prior to their arrival will be required to quarantine for 4 days upon arrival and await a negative RT-PCR test taken on day four before they can be released from quarantine. Those who have not been fully vaccinated for 2 weeks before their arrival will be required to quarantine for 14 days. The 5th Annual University of the West Indies UWE Global Giving and 4th Annual National UWE Pelican Award Gala, which is to be held on Sunday, August 1st, has been scaled down this year to accommodate only 15 invited guests due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The theme for this year's event is Emancipate, Educate, Donate. In an interview with ZRZ News, head of the UWE Open Campus site in St. Kitts, Gail Gray Phillip, shared what persons can expect at the event.
As usual, we will have the Emancipation Proclamation that will be read. We will have messages from the Chancellor, from the Vice Chancellor, from different representatives of UWE alumni relations from in Jamaica. We'll also have message from the acting principal of the UWE Open Campus.
She also added that the UWE Global Giving component of the event, where persons can make donations to the university, will be running from August to September. Ms. Gray Phillip outlined how persons can make their donations.
So past students and friends, persons who would like to donate to the university can do so online. We can do so at the event, Global Giving event, but it's limited to just 15 persons, so I'm sure there are thousands of others who are willing to give, and you can do so online at www.uwi.edu/giving. And you can indicate whether you want to donate to the hall that you lived on while you were at UWE, the faculty, a particular foundation. You can also indicate whether you want to donate to one of the sites, for example, the St. Kitts and Nevis site. You can indicate where you'd want to have your donations go towards.
The event is held in collaboration with the St. Kitts and Nevis UWE Alumni Association. Newly elected president of the association, Jian Williams, said this event is a way for the alumni to give back to the university and to offer support to students.
We think that it's an excellent opportunity for alumni to give back to the institution that has given us so much. So in this way, we can engage our alumni and find different ways that we can support other students as well. And also to highlight some of the prestige and excellence that has come out of the University of the West Indies.
Gray Phillip noted that during the UWE Alumni Day ceremony in June, the St. Kitts and Nevis chapter was awarded Most Impactful Alumni for its annual Global Giving Day and Pinnacle Award Gala. The event will be held in the State Room of Government House under the distinguished patronage of the Governor General. Persons can watch the event live on ZRZ TV and online on UWE's Facebook and YouTube pages. The event begins at 5 p.m. The Alternative Lifestyle Pathway Program, ALPP, was the recipient of 10 bags of charcoal, which were made and donated by the ALPP Parsons Group on Monday. According to group member Devon Watley, the production of the charcoal came out of another project that was being undertaken by the Passons group.
This donation was materialized from the hard work of the Passons ground team and in conjunction with the STEP program. One of the very first initiatives was the preservation of the grape trees along the island main roads in the community. In doing so, an idea created another idea, which led to using the discarded wood as something that is still in very high demand, which is coals. We hope that this donation can help our brothers and sisters who are presently going through difficult times.
Senior coordinator of the ALPP, Dwight Ward, commended the group's participants for taking the initiative to assist persons within the community.
I would like to say, on behalf of the Alternative Lifestyle Pathway Program, a very hearty thank you to the Passons group for the donation that they have made. This have shown that we are going in the right direction. These individuals have taken the opportunity to use materials to make coals and find themselves here this morning presenting these coals to the Alternative Lifestyle Pathway Program. This initiative goes a very, very long way. There are persons in our community at this particular time who are in need of such product, and of such we would be able to give these products to some persons in the community.
Watley also thanked Senator Honorable Bernice Nisbet, CEO of Development Bank Lentworth Harris, and Prime Minister Dr. the Honorable Timothy Harris for the support offered to the Alternative Lifestyle Pathway Program. And finally, the local scene. In the age of COVID, being able to make online purchases has become vital to maintaining physical distancing. In St. Kitts and Nevis, that has increased over the past 2 years. And the TDC group of companies is the latest to join the local fleet of online merchants with the launch of its website on Thursday. The shoptdcgroup.com platform enables shopping from its departments such as furniture, household and appliances, stationery and office supplies, home and building, and lawn and gardening, among others. Persons can sign up for accounts, save lists to their accounts, and or make purchases right away. Orders are processed immediately, and items will be delivered within 2 to 4 working days or can be collected from in-store. Purchases and deliveries extend to Nevis as well. Coming up in regional news, St. Lucia Prime Minister Philip J. Pierre outlines agenda. The details when we come back.
Yo, you look like the dude who was shopping at furniture and appliances.
See, my friend, you look like you buy something from the Ashley Home Store.
How you know?
Because we get the cashback coupons and the free groceries for a year!
Cashback is back at Horsford's Furniture and Appliances and Ashley Furniture. Shop now and get a chance to win free groceries for 1 year!
Agility Exports today at 1-246-417-0477. or email us at info@agilityexports.com to get yours now.
It's time to prepare for an A-plus this term with back-to-school deals from Courts. Shop today for laptops, tablets, printers, and more for a chance to win $1,000 cash. Get it now with Courts Ready Finance and pay nothing for 60 days. Save big with great deals only from Courts, bringing value home.
The St. Kitts and Nevis Chamber of Industry and Commerce would like to remind persons when patronizing businesses to abide by the following COVID-19 guidelines to protect employees, customers, and our community. Urge employers to check employees and customers with a non-contact head thermometer on arrival to a business place. It's mandatory that employees wear a face mask when at work and in the presence of others. No customers will be permitted to enter an establishment without a face mask. Encourage both employees and customers to wash their hands with soap and water or sanitize their hands with an alcohol-based hand sanitizer of at least 60% alcohol when entering a building, after interacting with customers, and throughout the day. Remember to maintain 6 feet physical and social distancing. Consider installing barriers such as sneeze guards or partitions in high traffic areas to limit close contact between employees and customers. Clean and disinfect highly touched surfaces such as doorknobs, telephones, cash registers, bathrooms, tables, and countertops regularly throughout the day. Offer e-commerce services or curbside pickup options wherever possible. Encourage good hygiene practices among staff and customers by posting signs and posters in the business place. For more information and tips to consider, visit www.covid19.gov.kn.
And we're moving now to news on the regional scene. St. Lucia's Prime Minister Philip J. Pierre, who vowed to put St. Lucia first, outlined some of his plans for the new Labour Party administration during his swearing-in ceremony on Wednesday. Here's Mark.
It's official. Philip J. Pierre has been sworn in as Prime Minister of St. Lucia. The auspicious occasion took place right here where I stand at the Governor General's residence on Wednesday, July 28, 2021.
Following the swearing-in ceremony, Pierre fielded questions from members of the media. He responded to what he believes may be one of his biggest challenges after taking the reins of power.
I have to bring some level of normalcy, some level of togetherness, some level of trust. I mean, you can't have in this country, no one seems to trust anybody. You can't trust the government. I always said, that if a country cannot trust the words coming from its leadership, from its leader, then something's wrong with that country.
As for the Prime Minister's top priority, it remains the health of the nation.
We have to get St. Jude Hospital open. We have no choice. I know many people are speaking about finding out how much money was spent at St. Jude. I will find that out too. But my main objective is to get these people out of the stadium. These people have been in that stadium now for 12 years. While politicians argue, while politicians make threats at each other, while politicians call the police to look for equipment. I mean, this, and the people are suffering.
Pierre affirms that as St. Lucia's Prime Minister, victimization of opposition members will be a thing of the past.
There are two members in the opposition and two independents. We will give them the respect. We will not invite them to cry. We will not wish that they cried anymore. We will not starve them of resources. I've taken the position publicly, and I'm going to ensure that each parliamentarian will receive an allocation for its constituency.
The formalities of handing over power from the United Workers' Party administration to the St. Lucia Labour Party administration is now officially complete.
Pierre says in the coming days he will be announcing his cabinet of ministers as he looks forward to a smooth transition. From inside the Governor General's residence, Solange Alfred, HTS News Force.
Scores of Cuban medical personnel are assisting Trinidad and Tobago in its COVID-19 fight. Cuba's ambassador to the country, Tania Diego Olite, says her countrymen are standing side by side on the high care unit and intensive care unit wards. Terrian Brown-Campbell tells us more.
In May 2020, with our borders closed, Cuban doctors and nurses began arriving in Trinidad and Tobago to bolster our own medical personnel in fighting the coronavirus. And Cuba's ambassador to Trinidad and Tobago, Tania Diego Olite, notes that cooperation is continuing.
And recently, last June 25, arrived another group of more than around 29 nurses in order to specialize in high intensive cares in order to help in this fighting of the pandemic in Trinidad. So,
Ambassador Olite says Cuba was forced to develop its biotechnology industry because of the U.S. blockade of the island.
Because this industry has been created 30 years ago. We have been creating vaccines that only Cuba had, like anti-meningococci, vaccine of the Spanish hepatitis.
Hepatitis.
This means Cuba is the only nation in the region that does not have to purchase COVID-19 vaccines because they have their own.
So Cuba is celebrating and is with a huge joy when they knew the efficacy of the vaccine and that 92.28%. So and also Soberana because of the trials, and it's 100% efficacy. To the death or preventing people to death.
Ambassador Olite was a guest on the Tuesday night talk show hosted by the Movement for Social Justice. Terrianne Brown-Campbell, TTT News.
Coming up, England scraps quarantine for fully vaccinated. We'll tell you more when we come back.
Imagine having the luxury of putting all your trust in one insurance company and being able to enjoy life to the fullest without having to worry. Well, don't imagine. National Caribbean Insurance is here to take care of all your insurance needs. Insure your life, vehicle, boat, home, belongings, and your future. At NCI, we make it our business to ensure that you enjoy every stage in life. We serve. We protect. We satisfy. That's NCI.
Welcome back. England will allow fully vaccinated visitors from the European Union and United States to arrive without needing to quarantine from next week in a huge and long-awaited boost for airlines and travel companies. More in this Reuters report.
England announced on Wednesday it will allow fully vaccinated visitors from the United States and the European Union to visit without needing to be quarantined. A huge and long-awaited boost, not just for those separated from loved ones, but for airlines and travel companies, which have been pushing for an easing of restrictions. British Transport Secretary Grant Shapps.
We've always said we need to move in line with what's going on in the real world. Obviously, people being vaccinated in Europe and in America now means that we can move to that next stage, which is allowing people to come here. And if they are double vaccinated, avoid having to quarantine as long as they've taken a test before they leave and after they arrive.
Britain's travel industry has criticized the government for being too slow to open up, saying it has squandered its lead in the global vaccine rollout and given the EU a head start in attracting tourists. The new rule, which takes effect on August 2nd, currently only applies to England, but is widely expected to be followed by the rest of Britain shortly. The government said international cruise sailings could also restart from England. Weighed down by cumulative pandemic losses of $4 billion, airlines such as British Airways and Britain's biggest airport, Heathrow, welcomed the move, but said more was needed to be done if the industry is to recover from a collapse in demand. Vaccinated travelers also still have to take a COVID-19 test before departure and shortly after arrival in England.
Thousands of people remain without essential provisions after the floods in Belgium, which killed at least 41 people 2 weeks ago. Euronews has the story.
Basements like this were destroyed when they were completely submerged during the flooding in Belgium in mid-July.
No, it's all cut. We don't have gas, nothing at all. You can look at it.
Nearly 2 weeks after the floods, here in the town of Verviers, there are still hundreds of homes which remain uninhabitable. Some have running water, but most are without electricity and gas.
Maintenant, on attend. Maintenant, on n'est pas le premier, on n'est pas les derniers. Tu vois, on est beaucoup, tu vois.
While at least 41 people lost their lives in the floods in Belgium, Verviers was one of the worst hit towns. Videos of cars flowing down the street were shared worldwide. Those same cars are now being removed from the River Vesdre. These men come from the German-speaking enclave and are donating their crane services for free.
Ich gehe abends nach Hause, leg mich in mein Bett, gehe mich duschen und das ist das, was die Leute hier nicht mehr haben. Die haben gar nichts mehr, ist alles weg.
A car park in the centre of Verviers has become a makeshift landfill site for the enormous piles of possessions destroyed by the floodwater. Here, charity support is filling in where the local government appears to be struggling.
La bourgmestre, je l'ai jamais vue, elle m'a jamais appelé. Nous avons nourri au moins jusqu'à présent, je crois, au moins 20,000 personnes.
Small businesses are salvaging whatever they can. The owners of this corner shop say they don't know what else to do.
On a ajouté plein, on a ajouté les congélateurs, les frigos, les caisses, tout.
202 of the 262 communes in the Wallonia region of Belgium have been told they'll qualify for disaster relief funding from the government. It will be welcome alongside insurance payouts, but that's a long way off. And the cleanup will take months, if not years. Jack Parrick, Euronews, Verviers.
Up next is sports. SKNFA nomination day held on Thursday. And league leader St. Paul's FC in the spotlight. Stay with us.
Imagine having the luxury of putting all your trust in one insurance company and being able to enjoy a life to the fullest without having to worry. Well, don't imagine. National Caribbean Insurance is here to take care of all your insurance needs. Insure your life, vehicle, boat, home, belongings, and your future. At NCI, we make it our business to ensure that you enjoy every stage in life. We serve. We protect. We satisfy. That's NCI.
We know there are moments when life just doesn't go as planned and our days pretty much takes us where it wants to. But for every missed occasion, there's a great opportunity. We are making it easier to make bill payments, report faults, and receive bill balances through our automated call-in service available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Simply call 465-2000 and say or press 2 to access our automated customer service system. Say or press 2 to make a payment via credit card. Enter your 8-digit Skillet account number as seen on your bill. Enter the amount you wish to pay without a decimal point. For example, enter 2000 for a $20 payment. Have your credit card on hand to enter your credit card number, expiration date, and security number. One phone call gives you the power to regain control of your day. Skillet Interactive Voice Response System. Skillet. Powering responses.
First up in sports, Thursday was nomination day for the upcoming SKNFA general elections, and the names of candidates were submitted to contest positions in the executive next month. Don Grant is among those vying for presidency, and on Thursday he launched his slate of candidates. They are Don Grant for president, Cornel Williams for first vice president, and Tanya Lawrence for second vice president. Other candidates for executive members are Raymond Brantley, Dwyer Edmead, Marjorie Jordan, Joseph Wilson, Kendale Liburd, Almon Crook, and Carlton Pinney. Speaking with ZIZ Sports, Mr. Grant said his team's focus will be on developing the sport and ensuring equity for all.
We're here to make the Federation game famous, the love of our lives, the best that we can be. the best that it can be by making sure that we are sharing equally every part of what we have in terms of resources to build the sport.
He said the goal is to use the sport as a vehicle to uplift the country as a whole.
We want to make sure that ladies, men, boys and girls benefit and grow from the sport. The intention is to use the sport for social development for St. Kitts and Nevis.
This week, Atiba Harris launched his team of candidates for the St. Kitts Nevis Football Association general elections, which will be held on August 29th. As we await the restart of the SKNFA Premier League, the Football Association will be featuring the 12 teams in the Premier League. Today, we profile league leaders St. Paul's FC. Andre Huey has the report.
The St. Kitts Nevis Football Association Premier League has been on break since the ending of May 2021 due to the COVID-19 outbreak in the Federation. Competition was suspended in the early part of round two, with the SL Horses and Paul's United leading the table. Now, with sporting organizations given the all clear to host events, the SKNFA announced to its member clubs that the Premier League will resume on September 18th, followed by other football competitions. While we wait for football to resume, the SKNFA will feature the teams in the country's highest level of football competition and how they have performed this season. We begin with league leaders SL Horsford, St. Paul's. St. Paul's entered this season with the high hopes of retaining the SKNFA Premier League title. After their sensational 2020 title win, led by their talisman Keith Roy Freeman, St. Paul's added more ammunition to their potent strike force. The league's second highest scorer last season, Vince Roy Nelson from Cairn. The dynamic duo wasted no time to show their goal-scoring prowess. Football commentator and pundit Sylvester Charles lauded St. Paul's longevity and consistency for their success so far in the league.
Congratulations to St. Paul's. They have really been playing well, tremendous football from the start of the league. They have maintained a very high standard. They were fortunate against Vince Roy Nelson from Cairn. That's another very exciting player who had transferred, strengthening the offense of the St. Paul's team. And then you had Keith Roy Freeman. You can't say much about Keith Roy Freeman. He's almost unstoppable on the field of play. And with players like those from St. Paul's, and the attitude generally from the players out of St. Paul's, it's like really true defending champions. I think they deserve the position that they're in. They are well supported by their fans and by management. And you could see when they come out to play, they have the attitude of winners. They are champions. And so they exhibit that onto the field of play. So I think they're going to be a very difficult team to beat.
Their only blunder was losing to St. Peter's FC in the first round. In that match, they were without Keith Roy Freeman and Nelson, who were in quarantine after returning from international duty in World Cup qualifiers. Interestingly, they succumbed in the late stages of the match to a free kick from former St. Paul's player Aidan Nurse, who returned to his boyhood club after winning the title with St. Paul's last year.
It up and over.
It comes in the net. Nurse beat the keeper, beat the wall, and St. Paul is in awe.
But even with the defeat, St. Paul's kept moving like a runaway train. It will be left to see if the long layoff from football will have any impact in St. Paul's efforts to retain the Premier League title.
And that's it for sports. When we come back, we'll have another look at the stories that made the headlines.
The Prime Minister of St. Kitts and Nevis, Dr. the Honorable Timothy Harris, wants to alert the public about fake Facebook and social media accounts that are circulating. These sites may look genuine, but they're not. These fake sites may use the Prime Minister's photo and name, but their only intention is to spread misinformation through false and scandalous information. Some of these pages are scams and will attempt to dupe you out of money. Do not trust them. You can find the real Prime Minister Harris on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram by searching for his official handle, which is at PMHarrisKN. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram pages that claim to be the Prime Minister's but do not have PMHarrisKN right after the forward slash are fake accounts. These should be reported to the respective social media sites. You can also report fake social media accounts to presssec@gov.kn. That's PRESSSEC@gov.kn. Facebook has verified Prime Minister Harris's official page by placing a white check mark inside a blue circle next to the Prime Minister's name, Dr. the Honorable Timothy Harris. This blue circle appears just above at PM Harris KN. Also, be alert. If the person claiming to be either the Prime Minister or another government official asks you for money through instant messenger, direct message, or any other means, this is a scam and not a real charity. This public service announcement was produced in order to help you be an informed social media user. Protect yourself and help spread the message.
And we're wrapping up with a recap of the top stories. Police investigating shooting in Nevis. Governor General receives credentials from UK High Commissioner. And UK High Commissioner holds a virtual meeting with Prime Minister Harris. And that's the end of this Eliza Channel 5 newscast. Thank you for joining us. I'm Caleb Berridge. Bye.